Good morning. Now, in this video lecture, we are going to study about the topic of bioenergetics and metabolism, that is oxidative phosphorylation. There are two very important parts in the cell metabolism, which generate the energy in large amount. And these two processes where majority of the ATP synthesis takes place are oxidative phosphorylation and photophosphorylation. Oxidative phosphorylation is a combination of energy yielding metabolism in the aerobic organisms, where this process it takes place both in autotrophs as well as in heterotrophs, whereas photophosphorylation it takes place in the autotrophic organisms, where the organisms they are able to synthesize their own food through the way of photosynthesis. There are certain common features of oxidative phosphorylation and photophosphorylation in that in both the processes there is a transfer of electrons, there is a process of oxidation, and finally the transfer of electrons, the transmembrane transfer of protons, it generates the number of ATPs, and the amount of ATPs generated in both the cases is very high as compared to any of the other metabolic process. So together oxidative phosphorylation and photophosphorylation account for most of the ATP synthesized by the most of the organisms and most of the time. In eukaryotes, oxidative phosphorylation it occurs in mitochondria, photophosphorylation in chloroplast. Oxidative phosphorylation it involves the reduction of oxygen to water with electrons donated by NADH and FADH2, and these two molecules NADH and FADH2, this oxidation it occurs equally well in light and darkness, whereas photophosphorylation involves the oxidation of water into oxygen with NADP as ultimate electron acceptor, and it is absolutely dependent on the energy of light. Despite their differences, these two highly efficient energy converting processes, they are fundamentally similar with respect to their mechanisms. Now, this oxidative phosphorylation, which is a culmination of the energy yielding metabolism, it consists of two parts. One is the electron transfer reaction and another is the phosphorylation reaction. The oxidation reaction, it takes place via the transfer of electrons through the electron carriers, which are located in the membrane. The part of the cell, the organelle of the cell where the oxidative phosphorylation it takes place is mitochondria in case of eukaryotic cells, whereas in case of prokaryotic cells the electron transfer carriers, these complexes, they are present in the plasma membrane, whereas in case of eukaryotes it is in the inner membrane of the mitochondria. There are certain specific features of mitochondria where mitochondria it has the outer membrane, it has the inner membrane. Inside the inner membrane there is matrix, and these outer membranes and inner membranes they have different permeabilities for different compounds. So the outer membrane is permeable to certain more compounds, whereas the inner membrane is highly permeable, I mean it is selectively permeable for some specific compounds. So there cannot be large great amount of exchange of proteins or any other compounds across the inner membrane. They are highly selective in their feature or transport. Now, this electron transport chain, it consists of four different complexes. These four different complexes, they are termed as complex 1, complex 2, complex 3 and complex 4. Through these different complexes, the electrons are transferred from the electron donor to the electron acceptor. Now the electron donor in case of oxidative phosphorylation and the electron donors which donates the electrons to the electron transport chain complexes, these are either NADH or FADH2. Now this NADH and FADH2, these are generated during the oxidative processes or the catabolic processes of metabolism, where the it can be generated in the glycolysis, it can be generated in the oxidation of glucose, that is the first state glycolysis. Then further it can be generated from pyruvate to acetyl-CoA formation. Then it can be generated during the acetyl-CoA getting converted into citric acid via the citric acid cycle. And this whole oxidation process of glucose liberates NADH and FADH2. Similarly, the other energy containing food which is getting oxidized, they also get oxidized, and the product of this oxidation, one of the product may be ATP, another product may be GTP directly, which are generated during the metabolic processes, and there are certain other products like the electrons which are removed during this oxidation processes, and these electrons, they are accepted by this electron acceptors which are NAD plus and FAD. And this NAD plus and FAD, when they accept the electrons, it gets reduced to NADH plus H plus, and FAD gets reduced to FADH2. Now this NADH and FADH2, which are generated during these oxidative metabolic processes, these electrons, these are carried to the electron transport chain, where these electrons are finally transferred or donated to the final electron acceptor, which can be oxygen in case of aerobic organisms, which can be any other inorganic compound in case of anaerobic organisms, or during the processes where the cellular where there is a deficiency of oxygen, where there is unavailability of oxygen. In some cases, in some organisms, the electron is finally accepted by the inorganic compounds. So, the electrons transferred by NADH and FADH2, finally they are transferred through the electron transport chain and donated to the electron acceptor. So, there the whole oxidation process of oxidative phosphorylation, it completes. Now, we will look into the different complexes, the different reactions which takes place in the different complexes of electron transport chain. As I have told you that the electron transport chain, it is present in the inner membrane of the mitochondria. The NADH and FADH2, which are synthesized inside the matrix with the during the metabolic processes, these electron carriers, they donate the electrons to the different complexes of electron transport chain. Particularly NADH plus H plus, the electrons are donated to complex 1. Now this complex 1 of electron transport chain, it is the NADH ubiquinone oxidoreductase or NADH dehydrogenase complex. And this is the enzyme protein enzyme complex which accepts the electron from the NADH, and it reduces NAD, it oxidizes NADH into NAD plus, and the electrons, these are carried from NADH to the FMN. Now this complex 1, it carries certain FES centers in this enzyme. There are several FES centers which accepts the electrons from the NADH and transfers it from one FES center to another FES center. So after accepting the electron from NADH, one FES center will get reduced. When this is getting reduced, After transferring the electron from one FeS to another FeS, the first FeS will get oxidized and the second will get reduced, and thereby several oxidation reduction reaction takes place, and from here the electron is finally transferred, that is from complex 1 the electron is finally transferred to quinone. So therefore this complex, it is also termed as NADH ubiquinone oxidoreductase. This large enzyme, it is composed of 42 different polypeptide chains, so it is a bigger complex which contains FMN, that is the flavoproteins, and at least 6 iron sulfur centers. So these iron sulfur centers, these are actually helping in the transfer of the electron from complex 1 to quinone. This complex 1, which catalyzes 2 simultaneous and obligatory coupled processes. One is the hexagonic one, that is the transfer of electron to ubiquinone. So the reaction is NADH plus H plus plus quinone forming NAD plus, that is the reduced that is the oxidized form, and the reduced form of quinone, that is QH2. Now with this transfer of electron, there is a certain amount of energy, the free energy which is liberated, so that is the hexagonic, and in this case the delta G is it carries a negative value, so it has a large delta G, minus delta G or negative delta G, and this hexagonic transfer of electrons to ubiquinone, it is simultaneously followed or coupled with the endergonic transfer, endergonic reaction. Now this endergonic reaction, it uses the free energy from the first hexagonic reaction, and there is a simultaneous transfer of 4 protons across the membrane. This is the matrix side of the mitochondria. This is the intermembrane space of the mitochondria. So from the matrix, 4 protons are translocated across the inner membrane, and it gets transferred to the intermembrane space. So this transfer is possible because of the hexagonic reaction or hexagonic transfer of electrons via complex 1. Now with this, the number of protons in the matrix has reduced, and in the matrix, whereas the number of protons in the intermembrane space has increased by 4. This ubiquinol, which is the complete reduced form of quinone, that is QH2, the fully reduced form, it diffuses in the inner mitochondrial membrane from complex 1 to complex 3. So this quinone, it is of the movable type, it can diffuse inside the membrane, and the electron which is transferred by complex 1 to quinone, now this ubiquinone form, it can get diffused in the inner membrane, and from the electron which is transferred from complex 1, it transfers it to complex 3. So that was the reaction as at complex 1, where complex 1 accepts the electron from NADH, transfers it to quinone, reduces it to ubiquinol or QH2, and this hexagonic reaction is coupled with the endergonic reaction, that is translocation of 4 protons across the inner mitochondrial membrane from matrix into the intermembrane space. Then you have a complex 2. This complex 2, this accepts the electrons from FADH2, and this FADH2, it is the enzyme linked cofactor, and that enzyme where it is linked is succinate dehydrogenase. This succinate dehydrogenase is the only membrane bound enzyme in the citric acid cycle, which contains 5 prosthetic groups of 2 types and 4 different protein subunit. So FAD, it is actually linked to this succinate dehydrogenase complex, and the path of electron transfer from succinate binding site to FAD, then through FA centers to quinol or ubiquinone binding site. So what happens here is when there is conversion of succinate to fumarate in the citric acid cycle, this there is a dehydrogenation of succinate, that is there is oxidation of succinate into fumarate. So there is removal of electrons from succinate. These electrons which are removed from the succinate are accepted by FAD. This FAD is linked to succinate dehydrogenase complex, and this FAD accepts the electron to form FADH2. This reduced form of FAD, that is FADH2, it then transfers its electron to the FA centers of succinate dehydrogenase. In that case, FADH2 is reoxidized to FAD and the FA center gets reduced. Now this FAD center which is getting reduced, they transfer electron from one FA center to another FA center, where one FAS will get reduced by accepting the electron. After donating the electron, it gets oxidized. So again there is oxidation reaction and reduction reaction which takes place. And finally, from the FAS centers, the electron is transferred to ubiquinone and reduces it to UQH2. This is one of the type of transfer of electron from FADH2 to complex 2. There are two more enzymes which are involved in this transfer of FADH2, the electron transfer from FADH2. One is acyl-CoA dehydrogenase, that is the FAD-linked acyl-CoA dehydrogenase enzyme, which is an enzyme of fatty acid oxidation. And there is another enzyme, glycerol-3-phosphate dehydrogenase, which is the enzyme responsible for transfer of electrons from NADH generated in the cytoplasm. In the cytoplasm, one example is the process which oxidation process which takes place in the cytoplasm is glycolysis. And during glycolysis, there is production or generation of NADH plus H+. That NADH plus H+, which is generated, the electron from NADH which are produced in the cytoplasm are not transferred to the complex 1 of the inner mitochondrial membrane, the electron transport chain. Instead, these electrons carried by NADH, they are transferred to complex 2 via shuttle system. And the shuttling of the electrons from NADH, from the cytoplasmic NADH to the inner mitochondrial membrane complex 2 is done through glycerol-3-phosphate dehydrogenase enzyme. And this shuttling transfers the electron finally to complex 2. So there are two things here. One is NADH, which is there inside the mitochondrial matrix, transfers the electron to complex 1. The FADH2, which is there in the matrix of the mitochondria, is transferred to complex 2. Whereas the NADH, which is produced in the cytoplasm, that electron from NADH is transferred to complex 2, not to complex 1. Now from here, this is the better clear picture for the transfer of electrons by these three mechanisms to complex 2. One is the succinate dehydrogenase, succinate to fumarate conversion. There is another one, which is the acyl-CoA dehydrogenase, and there is glycerol-3-phosphate dehydrogenase shuttle reaction, transferring its electron to FAD and finally to quinol. So now we have the reduced form of ubiquinone, that is QH2, which is formed from either the donation of electron from complex 1 or the donation of electron from complex 2 to ubiquinone or Q. This ubiquinone now transfers the electron to complex 3. So, whether the electron is coming from complex 1 or whether the electron is coming from complex 2, the electron carrier is ubiquinone, and the reduced form of ubiquinone, that is the QH2, then it diffuses through the inner membrane and transfers the electron to complex 3. So this complex 3, it is accepting the electron from ubiquinone, and the complex 3, which is also known as ubiquinone, which is also known as cytochrome C or cytochrome, it is a BC1 complex or ubiquinone cytochrome C oxidoreductase. Here ubiquinone is transferring the electron to complex 3, so it is getting oxidized and cytochrome is getting reduced. So together it is known as ubiquinone cytochrome C oxidoreductase. So this oxidoreductase reaction at the cytochrome, there are two reactions which take place. One is, there is acceptance of electron from ubiquinone, that is UPH2 getting converted to Q. There is another reaction where Q is donating the electron or transferring the electrons to this cytochrome, and then there is formation of the superoxide molecule or radical. The first transfer of electron by the reduced quinone gives you UQH2 plus Q plus cytochrome C1 getting reduced to Q plus Q radical plus 2 protons plus cytochrome C reduced form. And then there is another reaction where you have UQH2 plus Q radical plus 2 protons plus Q plus cytochrome C oxidized form, where the there is a radical getting converted to Q and 2 protons translocation, QH2 formation plus cytochrome C which is getting reduced. So in this case there is oxidation of QH2 to Q, and in this case there is reduction of this radical into Q, and during these processes there is translocation of protons, 2 protons during first reaction, 2 protons during second reaction, and there is a total of translocation of 4 protons across the membrane. So during this case what we can see is there is reduction of complex 3, that is cytochrome C, and there is transfer of 4 protons across the membrane from the matrix to the intermembrane space. So in case of complex 3 also, there is transfer of electron, which is the hexagonic process, and there is translocation of protons, which is the endergonic process. So that this also is a coupled reaction of translocation of protons to the transfer of electrons. That is the complex 3. The same reaction, the coupled reaction, is also there in complex 1. Now, up till now there has been a transfer of electron from complex 1, complex 2, complex 3. Out of that, there is translocation of 4 protons across the membrane from the electron transfer reaction across, from cytoplasm to intermembrane space, 4 protons. And through the complex 3, again there is translocation of 4 protons because of the transfer of electrons. Now, from complex 3, the electrons are further transferred to complex 4. This complex 4 is cytochrome oxidase. So, complex 4, this is an enzyme which is known as cytochrome oxidase. This oxidase enzyme or cytochrome oxidase enzyme, it accepts the electrons from complex 3. So, the electrons from complex 3 are transferred to complex 4. The electrons are transferred by cytochrome C to cytochrome oxidase, and that pair of electrons which is transferred, it is finally then submitted or donated to the final electron acceptor, which is oxygen in case of aerobic organisms. Now here there is transfer of 2 electrons, there is transfer of 2 protons to oxygen, getting reduced to water. So with transfer of 1 pair of electrons, there is generation of 1 molecule of water, and 2 pairs of electrons accepted by 1 molecule of oxygen, giving you 2 molecules of water. So with the transfer of a pair of electron from the complex 4 to oxygen producing water, this reaction is also coupled with transfer of protons. Here it is shown 4 protons. Actually there is pumping of 2 protons across the membrane from the mitochondrial matrix to the intermembrane space. Now this translocation of proton, it is an endergonic reaction again, and this happens or this occurs because of the transfer of pair of electrons from cytochrome to oxygen. So the overall reaction for this is, there are 4 cytochrome C which are reduced, then there are 8 protons and oxygen, getting 4 cytochrome C oxidized, 4 protons across the membrane and 2 water molecules. So actually there is translocation of 2 proton molecules, and if you look into the total number of protons which are translocated while there is a transfer of a pair of electrons from complex 1, 2, 3 and 4, we had 8 protons translocated earlier from complex 1, 4, from complex 3, 4, so 4 plus 4, 8. And now there are 2 more protons which are translocated, so there are total 10 protons which gets translocated across the inner membrane of mitochondria as a result of transfer of electrons. And finally there is the electron acceptance by oxygen. So the whole oxidation completes with the final electron acceptor, that is the oxygen. So this is the electron transfer chain reactions which are showing the complete oxidation of the electrons which are carried by the electron carriers. So finally a pair of electron is transferred from NADH plus H plus and FADH2 via electron transport chain, which are finally accepted by the oxygen. And this process of electron transfers, it finally results into two things. One is there is production of water, and there is translocation of protons across the membrane. So there is a reduction in the number of protons of the matrix, and thereby concentration of the protons in the matrix, and there is increase in the concentration of protons in the intermembrane space. So this result, what it actually does is that because of the reduction in the number of protons in the matrix, the pH increases in the matrix, and because of the increase in the number of protons in the intermembrane space, the concentration increases and therefore the pH reduces. Now this differences in the pH, or this differences in the concentration of protons across the inner membrane of mitochondria, this creates the pressure across the membrane, which actually then ultimately further leads to production of ATPs. So that we will look into another lecture, how the ATPs are synthesized and how this concentration variations across the membrane, how it is helpful in the production of ATPs. This ends with the electron transport chain finally donating the electron to the electron acceptor, that is the oxygen. Thank you.